If you've been working with Excel for a while, most likely you've seen the percent icon on the Home tab. This changes number formats to percentages by multiplying them by 100, then adding the percent sign. So we can change decimals to percentages in literally one click. But that's just formatting, not calculation. There isn't a function to calculate percentages. The standard math formula is easy enough, so we just apply it. In Excel, formulas start with an equal sign, and a basic percentage formula has values being expressed as the numerator, and the whole is the denominator. They're separated by a slash. When we hit enter, Excel usually displays the result as a decimal, if the cell carried the general number format. And of course, we know that clicking the percent icon displays this value as a percentage. Since we know this, we can get down to how we work with percentages in Excel in everyday situations. Let's say that a survey was distributed to 1,400 people, and the results are shown on this spreadsheet. What percentage of the respondents answered, "Don't know"? Well, let's express each number as a fraction of the total, and then we can format that number as a percentage. We type equals B2 slash the sum of this entire range, B2 to B5. Since this range will remain fixed, we'll hit F4 to make it a fixed range so it doesn't shift when we copy the values down. If you're using a Mac, you can use Command T. We close parentheses and hit enter. And now we can copy our formula down, click on our percent icon, and we're good to go. What if you wanted to show an increase or decrease in a number as a percentage? On this sheet, we can see the number of hits to our website over the space of 2 months. For some cities, we had an increase, while others had fewer hits. We want column D to show February's increase or decrease over January's number as a percentage. So at first, February's change will be a fraction or decimal of January's figure. Let's get started. We'll type equals C2 minus B2. And we'll put this within parentheses because now we'll express this value as a fraction of the January figure. So slash B2. We hit enter and we can click on the fill handle twice to copy. Let's hit the percent icon. And now we have the increase or decrease shown as a percentage. What if we wanted to customize the appearance of these numbers, maybe by making the decreases, the negative values, stand out in red? To do that, we can click on the drop-down for the number formats and hit more number formats here, and we'll get a format cells window. Or we could hit Control 1 on our keyboard, whether Windows or Mac, and the same window will appear. Once we're in the Format Cells window under the Number tab, then we can click on the Custom Formats to create and save a customized format for use at another time. Let's get one that's close to what we're looking for. We scroll down and we are looking for one that puts negative values in red. Here we have it right at the bottom. So we want positive values to have the percentage sign. And we want negative values to be in red, also with a percentage sign. Notice that values are shown to two decimal places. We hit OK, and the formats on the cells we highlighted on our worksheet are adjusted. Here, we can change the number of decimal places. This decreases, and this increases the number of decimal places. And now, let's learn how to increase or decrease a number by a certain percentage. On this spreadsheet, we have the cost price on each item of produce. We want to display our selling price as a markup of 47%. So let's type selling price here. Now remember that 47% is really the same as 0.47. So now our goods will be sold for the original cost plus 0.47 of that cost. So we're asking Excel to calculate that. Let's type equals B2 times, and we can open parentheses here, 1 plus 47%. Close parentheses and enter. This is great because we can do this without the extra step of finding what is 47% and then adding it back to the original cost. So we double click to copy, and now we have the selling price of all our items of produce. Decreasing something by a percentage works in a similar way, but of course we'd subtract instead of adding. So let's delete this and say we were looking to offer a 33% sale. What we do is equals B2 times open parentheses 1 minus 33%, close parentheses and enter. Double click to copy, and now we have the selling price with a 33% discount. So once you get the hang of it, you'll wonder why you were doing this manually all along. Subscribe to our channel and get more time-saving tips from GoSkills.com.
Ready to learn more about Microsoft Excel? Then check out the full course on GoSkills.com. Click the link in the description.